Shalom, my people. Shalom. Peace be unto you. That's what that means. Peace be unto my people. Like I've been saying, none of this teaching, none of what you hear can benefit you if you don't grasp that you are the children of Israel. If you don't get that, you can't never, ever go anywhere. We'll still have the same mind frame what we have now. What you see on social media, that same mean, hateful mind frame, we'll have that because we are a people that's searching for an identity. Because they have stolen our identity, so we don't really know who we are. So we searching. It's like a kid that's been adopted, right? But he don't really know who his father is. So he always searching. He's angry. He get in trouble. You know what I'm saying? He can't figure it out. Everybody else has a mother and a father. And they know who they are. But we as a nation as a whole don't know who our father is. We've been taught so many different things with our father. We've been taught our father's a rock, Allah. We've been taught our father is any kind of doctrine that they throw upon. That's why they can just give you anything. That's why Jim Jones was able to kill so many people because they were looking for an identity. That's why preferable dollars able to get you with your money. Because you're looking for an identity. So anything make you feel good, you run to it as a nation of people. That's what we do. We follow any doctrine except for the Bible. Because they done brainwashed us to stay away from the Bible. We should be running to it. And once you read it, then you'll understand that we are the people in the Bible. Once you understand, you'll understand that we are the people in the Bible. Until we get that point across, it's nothing that really nobody can do. Nobody, somebody lost teaching you. But I give you scripture upon scripture and tell you the word. They stand up there and start talking about money and then close the Bible. And that got your attention because we're in a desperate need. Everybody is in a desperate need. Not just now, and back in the past. We've always been in a desperate need. So we continue to go through these problems until we find out who our real father is, who our real identity is. You know it when you don't know who you are. You just feel empty. We don't know who we are. We just an empty vessel. But I'm here today to give you some clarification of who you are. If you just follow and listen to me, when you go to my page, please miss like and subscribe. Miss like and subscribe. That's why I can get my views up, I can get across the nation. I need to get this message out because, hey, we're in the last time. And you don't want to be in that two-thirds. You want to be in that third. You done heard it throughout the generation where they tell you somebody was in the field plowing and they looked up and one was gone. Well, that's true. Two-thirds of us going to die. And a third going to be gone. It's in Zechariah. But let me get to the message right here. This is the message. This is what I'm telling you when we don't have an identity. This is what the Most High say in Jeremiah 17:4. And thou, even thou self, shall discontinue from thy heritage that I gave thee. And I will call thee to serve thy enemy in the land which thou knowest not, for ye have kindled a fire in my anger, which shall burn forever. That's what the Most High said. Because we disobeyed the law, statute, and commandments, and we done kindled the fire in the Lord. We kindled the fire in the Lord because of what we done. Because we disobeyed the law, statute, and commandments. The Bible is not a religion. It's law, statute, and commandment. It's 613. But they won't tell you that in church. They just tell you the 10. The 10 is just a guideline. But it's 613. They don't have nothing they're saying. In the 10, they don't have nothing saying you can't sleep with no animal. Can you sleep with an animal? No. That's in one of the 613. But they don't teach you that. It's a lot of laws in there. They tell you about eating shellfish. I have some close relatives And he usually he posted all every day. He been posting about crabs, cooking this, cooking crab, and all that. And I said, hey man, you gotta stop eating it. I got another close relative. They eat crab damn near every other day. Guess what? He died over type 2 diabetes. Because nobody want to know the law. They go to church, they sing, but that don't do no good. I promise you that ain't doing no good if you don't know the law. The law said that should discontinue from their heritage. And he going to make us serve our enemy. Right now, we serving our enemy. Every other nation is our enemy. You say, well, how you serving our enemy? Yeah, because they own all the stores. The Chinese you see on TV, they beating people. They telling the so-called Negroes and some of them Africans over there and some of them Negroes over there. They telling them that they can't come in their stores. They kicking them out. And then guess what I passed by? I passed by and I seen our people in the Chinese restaurant going through the drive-thru. Knowing they eat dogs and bats and stuff. We so destroyed as a people. It's crazy. We won't support our own. Now, I just seen something on Facebook going through the news feed that they want us to buy American-made stuff. They want to start buying American-made stuff. How you going to start buying American-made stuff when we got all the other nations in our neighborhood? All the other nations are in our neighborhood. We have nothing. We discontinue from our heritage. Okay, check this out. And people get... They so emotional. They hard be all there. Getting on so emotional. Take that emotional part out and you come and say, this is what the Lord said about the... This is what the Most High said about the heart. In Jeremiah 17:9, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? The Lord said that. Take your emotions out of it and use your mind. Use your mind. Your emotion will have you doing stuff you don't have no business. You feeling sorry for every other nation but your people. But if you take your mind and use your mind and take that emotion out of it, the Lord said the heart is deceitful. Because we got too much emotion tied up in it. Instead of having our mind tied up in it, we got emotion tied up in it. So we think that. Now we in Georgia, everybody has seen that now. The Lord said we shall serve our enemy. He said he would destroy us in front of our enemy. And that's what happened. He going to wake you up, people. I promise you. If y'all don't read Deuteronomy 28:1-16, y'all lost. That's one critical point in the Bible everybody need to read. White, black, green, purple, or whatever color you are. Then you'll know who you are. You'll know who them curses fit. The Lord said, I am going to destroy you. He's talking about us. You read the last video I had when I told you what the Lord said. He was so mad at us, he had to repent to himself. So the Lord said, I'm going to get your attention right now. So he killing us. The Most High is killing us. Nobody, he using people to do the work. They are killing, Lord, the Most High is killing us. Y'all don't want to hear that. You don't want to hear it because the preacher tell you God is love, love, love. He is not love like y'all think he is, man. He love you. You follow his laws. He love that. But he is killing us himself by using people just like he used throughout the Bible. Use people to do the work. He killing us, people. Until you get an understanding that he is killing us, you will never make it. The Most High is killing us. He using people to kill us because we have discontinued from our heritage. The Lord said, we serving enemies. We serving our enemies. I'm reading to you out of the scripture. Take your heart out of it. The Lord said, your heart is deceitful. Jeremiah 17:9. Let me move on. See, Jeremiah 6:17. Go back a couple books. Jeremiah 6:17. 6:17, please. The Lord sent out watchmen. Throughout the whole Bible, the Lord had always had people to tell his word. He had Moses. He had King David. He had King Solomon. He had Ezra. He had Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, the Maccabees, Tobit, Jude. He had all these people to tell us that he had watchmen over us. I am a form of a watchman. I am a form of a watchman. I am a watchman to tell you the truth. Them people told the truth. What the Lord said about the pastor today, he said, I'm going to destroy you for the woe unto the pastor that has scattered my flock. We are the flock. They have scattered us, misled us, and they had us in all kind of problems. That's why we are so much of the destroyed people now. Check it out. This is what he said. Jeremiah 6:17. Also, I would set a watchman over you, saying, hearken to the sound of the trumpet. But they say, we will not hearken. Hearken means you pay attention. You hear it. You listening. When the trumpet sounds, you know it's something happening. See, they used to sound the trumpet. Like when they, back in the biblical days, they would be on the watchtower. They had watchmen in the tower. When you would see the enemy come, they would sound the trumpet. Everybody would know to get ready. Well, I am your watchman telling you to get ready. I'm telling you to get ready for what's to come. The Lord is going to destroy you until you wake up. This is not the Lord that came the first time, meek as a lamb. He's going to destroy us until we wake up. Guess what? Go to Jeremiah 5:11. Jeremiah 5:11. Check this out. For the house of Israel and the house of Judah have dealt very treacherously against me, saith the Lord. The house of Judah is the first three tribes. We are the Jews. The first three tribes is the Jews. Judah, Benjamin, and Levite. Their white given name is Negro, West Indian, which is Trinidad, and Levi, which is Haiti. We are the Jews. Them three nations are the Jews. Okay? And Israel, the house of Israel, is the other nine. Zebulun, which is the Panamanian, Guatemalan, Ephraim, which is Puerto Rico, Manassas, which is Cuban, Gad, which is North American Indian, Reuben, which is the Seminole Indian, Naphtali, which is Argentino and Chile, Ashner, Colombia, and I can't get that one, it's kind of blurry. And Issachar, which is the Mexicans. Them is the house of Israel. We are the tribe of Judah. We from Judah. I just told you. Judah, Benjamin, Levi, the so-called Negro, West Indian, and Haiti. West Indian, which is Trinidad. And the Lord said that we have dealt treacherously against him, saith the Lord. So that's why we're going through what we're going through. They won't teach you that in church, but I'm teaching you this now. Take your heart out of it. Your heart is wicked. The Lord said the heart is deceitful. The heart is deceitful and above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? Take your heart out of it and listen to your mind. That's what the Lord is trying to tell you. That's why the Lord always say, when he said heart, he mean mind. Come on, people, man. I'm trying to give it to you straight. Okay, go to Jeremiah 4:22. Guess what it say? My people is foolish. They have not known me. They are Scottish children. And they have none understanding. They are wise to do evil. But to do good, they have no knowledge. Lord call us foolish. So when people say, you can't, God don't call people no fool. The Lord call us foolish. He call us Scottish children. That means foolish. Because the Lord said that my people are foolish. We are foolish. We'll do evil all day. We'll kill each other all day long, but we don't never think to talk things over. Because we have been destroyed as a people, and they continue destroying us. They separate us. They separate us through division, like put you in certain neighborhoods. Give certain people certain jobs. And then give you the attitude like you don't exist with them because them, even though they look like you and they're your people, but you better than them. You're in high class. You done moved on up like the Jefferson. You're moving on up. You up there. So you look down. See what I'm saying? So they using you to hurt your own people. Oh, they should have did it. They should have did what I did. But that ain't what the Lord meant for it to be. But we lost as a people. Go to Jeremiah, up a couple scriptures. Jeremiah 4:14. O Jerusalem, was thy heart from wickedness that thou may be saved? How long shall thy vain thoughts log with thee? We think nothing. We don't have no compassion for our people. We have compassion for them. We'll see them and have compassion for them, but you see your people, you got something negative to say. All we do, they show us just fighting each other. They didn't even quit. They don't show no other nation divided amongst themselves. But throughout all social media and the news, they show us killing us. They show us living like dogs. They show us in the bad situation. God, now guess what? All the statistics, what they saying, is almost right, if not dead on. Because Lord said he was going to destroy us. That's why we number one in everything that comes out. Number one, high blood pressure, cholesterol, heart attacks, every kind of disease, we are number one. Because guess what? The Most High sent the disease upon us because we disobedient children. If you don't believe me, read Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 1 through 15 tell you what would have happened if we would have obeyed the law. When you go to Deuteronomy 16, Deuteronomy 15 through 28, Deuteronomy 15 through 16 tell you all the curses that are upon us because we disobeyed the law. Jeremiah, right on a couple pages old, Jeremiah 3:15. I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. The Lord said, I am going to give you my personal pastors to teach you the word. And how you going to identify them? Because they're going to go scripture line upon line, precept upon precept. We're not going to change the word. We ain't asking for your money. We're not sitting around trying to get a $64 million jet. No, we're not doing none of that. We just teaching the word freely and feeling good about it. We don't want no money. Why in the world you got to go to a concert to listen to some pastors preach and pay $50 to get in? We are the most foolish people in the world. We are the most foolish people in the world. We are destroyed. Because guess what? Why in the world are you paying $50, $60, $70, $100 to go see a preacher preach the word of God, which is right here? When you can tune into me and I teach you the word of God for free. And once I be able to go live, I can go live and answer all your questions. And tell you where to go to find it for free. Search the description for free. Why are we paying these people this money? We are so foolish. Thus says the Lord. Lord called us foolish. Lord said, we are so foolish. Zephaniah, go to Zephaniah. Zephaniah 2:1. See, I do this. I take my time and I study this. Fucking give it to you. Give it to you correctly. Give you honest words. Not my words, but God's word. I'm giving you scripture and reading with you. If you got your Bible, you're going on with me. Please, I beg you, do not get them during New Edition Bibles. Get you a King James book, King James Bible 1611. I beg of you, get you a King James Bible 1611. You go get them NIV and all them other Bibles. They changed them. Some of them even took the scriptures out of the Bible. Some of them changed the words. Please, I beg of you to get you a King James 1611. Because if you don't, you read along with me, it sounds like I'm saying something different. Because you got a 16, you don't have a 16 James, 1611, King James. You don't have that. You got the Bible that they took out and searched the scripture and see that we read it now. So now they're coming out, they keep changing it. That's how you know the Bible is so powerful. Why did not change in the Quran? Why not they change Egyptology? They're only changing the Bible because we waking up and reading it. Zephaniah 2, gather yourself together. Yea, gather together, O nation not desired. The Lord telling us to gather ourselves together. Get your stuff together. Get your stuff. The Lord saying, get your stuff. Just like you would say, hey, you see somebody there, man, get your shit together. The Lord tells you to get your shit together. Gather yourself. Come together. I'm trying to give you this word free. Message like and message subscribe and get these free words. I got plenty of videos in here where you can learn from. And you ain't got to pay me no $50. They robbing us, man. Come on now. Jeremiah, go back to Jeremiah. Jeremiah 2:14. 2:14. Is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave? Why is he spoiled? This the Most High said, because we are the children of God. And God is saying, is Israel, he got a question mark about it. If you got a King James Version, 1611, he got a question. He's asking you, Israel, is you are serving? If you serving everybody else but the true living God? Is he a homeborn? If you're a homeborn slave, why is he spoiled? You are spoiled like spoiled me. Why are you spoiled? Why they done rob you all your identity? When I give it's right here. You got to come back. You come back, you can get all your identity. Come back to the Lord and know who you is. No, you're not a color. No, you're not this. You're not black. Oh, I'm black. How come you the only one changing your nationality every 10, 20 years? Every 10 years, I'm surprised they ain't changed it. Every 10 years, if you're in your 50 like me, you done witnessed by four different nationality changes. Jeremiah 8:3. This is a good lesson. This is what the Lord asked you a question. This is what the Lord said. And death shall be chosen rather than life by all the residue of them that remain of this evil family, which remain in all the places where I have driven them, said the Lord of hosts. The Lord called us an evil family. The 12 tribes of Israel, Lord called us an evil family. That's why all this stuff is happening to us. All 12 tribes, it's happening to them all over the world because we scattered all over the world. So it's happening to us all over the world. The Lord called us an evil family. Lord said we chose death rather than life because we disobeyed the law and the commandment. So we died. We died by the sword. We died by the pestilence, the sword, or the gun. The modern day gun. That's the sword. Why you seen that boy got shot down in the street when you seen the video? That's the modern day gun. That's the modern day sword. Shot him down. They hang us, they shoot us, they beat us, they do anything they want to us because, hey, guess what? God did it. God doing it. God doing this to us because we disobeyed the law, statute, and commandments. You don't want to believe it? Read the Bible. Take your emotions out of it and use your mind what the Lord said. The Lord said the heart is deceitful above all things. Who knows it? It's wicked. It's desperately wicked. Take your emotions out of it and use your mind like God said. We chose death rather than life. This is what the Most High is saying. I'm giving you scripture from scripture. You can't say I'm making it up. 9:16. I will scatter them also among the heathen, who neither their father have known, and I will send a sword after them till I have consumed them. You just read what the Lord just told us. The Lord said, I will send a sword. The Lord killing you. The Most High is killing you. That same God who you said is love. He love everybody. He killing your butt. He killing us right now today. He's killing you. Because we disobeyed the law. The Lord said, I'm not saying that the Lord said he's killing us. The Lord said, I scatter you. You all. That's why we all over the world. He took us out of our homeland. And he let them sold us into slavery. All everything you went through, all the atrocity, everything you ever going through in your life, God doing it to you. God doing it to you. God said, I sent a sword until I have consumed you, until I have killed you, until I have eaten you up alive. Who gonna give you this scripture straight like this here? You gonna go pay $50 for somebody to tinker with your old wicked heart? Jeremiah 16. I diligently looked up this stuff concerning us. Jeremiah 16:14-16. Therefore, behold, the day come, saith the Lord, that I will no more be said. Other words, like now, they take it off. Right now, you can't go. They put you in jail for going to church now. Now you can barely get the word over the internet now. They taking off all the Hebrew Israelite brothers off of YouTube. Off of YouTube. Now they got to find all the way to get the information to you. The Lord says, my word going to be scarce. You ain't going to be getting it like you was. The Lord liveth that brought up the children of Israel out of the land. The Lord the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. That's us. But the Lord liveth and brought the children out of the land, out of Israel, from the land of the north. That's where we had North America. And from all the land where he had driven them. Why the Lord keep telling you I drove you out of your land? He sent us into slavery. This is North America we in. He sent you into slavery. And from all the land where he had driven them. And I will bring them again into their land. The Lord said, he's going to bring us back into our homeland. And that I will give unto their father. He promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob the land of milk and honey. But right now, we're scattered. He's going to give us back our land in the end time. Okay, check this out. Behold, I will send many fishers, saith the Lord. They shall fish them. And afterward, I send for many hunters. And they shall hunt them from every mountain, from every hill, out of the holes and out of the rock. Lord sent them fishing. Now, I am a fisherman now. I'm fishing for your soul. I'm giving you the word of God. The true word of God. But then God said, going to come a time, he's going to send hunters. And hunters going to kill you. Hunt you down under the rock. Wherever you try to hide at, where you try to go in your bunkers at, he gonna hunt you down and kill you. He hunting us down now and killing us right now. Wherever you try to hide at, I don't care what neighborhood you move in. You can move right in the middle of the white people if you want to. Right in between two of them. And the Lord will hunt you down and kill you right there. That's what I'm saying, folks. I done read you the scriptures. I done gave you the word of God. I done gave you the word of God and gave you the scriptures of where to go. So you can't say I'm making this up. I gave you this. I give you the letter. I give you the word. I take my notes. I go down and I study these Bible. I study these scriptures. And I give you precept upon precept, line upon line. Everything I gave you backed up the first script I gave you. I read the second. It backed up the first one. I read the second one, the third one backed up the second one. I read the fourth one backed up I gave you line upon line to let you know that this is the real deal. I gave you line upon line to let you know that God will hunt you down and he's going to kill you. I don't care where you move at. The Lord said you can be hiding in Mr. Rock track. Wherever you try to hide at, I'm going to send people to get you. You can try to think, you say, I'm moving to a gated community. Lord, come to that gated community and get you. You can't hide. Oh, I'm going to build that house in the woods. Lord, I'm going to send sharks to eat you. I'm going to move out in the woods. The Lord going to send the man hunting to shoot you. The Lord going to hunt you down and kill you. Yes, it sounds scary. Yes, it is scary. That's the only thing we understand. We killing each other. Famine is coming. Now you want me to get two packs of meat. Wendy's talking about stop selling hamburgers. That's why the Lord said you're supposed to fast. Clean your body out. Train your body not to eat all that food. I know it's hard. I can tell you it's hard. We got to stay prayed up. Because the time is coming, folks. I do this all out of love. I'm here to tell you that you don't have to go pay $50 to go see no people, man. Y'all start boycotting that stuff, man. When they hear him come pay $50 to see them preach. Y'all stop that. Please stop that. The word is so simple you just studied. The main thing is the Lord said the heart is deceitful. Jeremiah 17:9. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. who can know it? That's what the Most High said. Because you put all your emotions in this stuff here instead of using your mind. And your emotions have you doing stuff you ain't got no business. Shalom, my people. Shalom. I love you very much. Hey, click the like button. Even subscribe. I'm going to give you this word, thus says the Lord. I promise you I'll never change from this word because God got this word in me. I am your watchman. Shalom, my people. Shalom.